General de Lafayette told me to go this way to enter the gardens, but how could he have managed to make it out alive? Trianon is at the end of this path. I cannot get to it. I'll have to enter the labyrinth.
Ah! Our plan is foolproof. Monsieur Cléry will be waiting for you at Gros Caillou at the appointed time. But I warn you, do not be late.
Don't worry, monsieur. I will not fail you.
Very well. As for the rest, everything is explained in this letter. Mesdames, the die is cast. In a week, God willing, you will be in Vienna, and the children under the Emperor's protection.
Quiet, someone is coming. Monsieur, you must leave.
Your Grace.
Monsieur, to what do we owe this honor?
Mesdames, we are in grave danger. In Paris, the people are up in arms. I've been informed that the rebels are marching on the palace.
What do you mean?
There is no need to be alarmed. You are to be taken to Saint-Cloud and placed under competent protection. Have your people prepare your things. You will leave Versailles in an hour.
Good heavens, my queen. How will I get to the children?
Oh, mon Dieu. All is lost.
Ages, where on earth have you been? Did you not receive my message ordering you to Saint-Cloud?
Yes, I did. But unfortunately, I was not able to answer your call.
My life was at stake. It was your duty to protect me.
Your life has no more value than that of your subjects, madame.
Grand Dieu! How dare you!
Madame, go and find the children. We must get going.
No, no. We can't. I can't.
The children here? At the Petit Trianon?
Yes. They are upstairs in the Queen's room.
General, you and I both know what is coming. You must take them to safety, post-haste.
No, I will not leave without Gabrielle.
Madame de Polignac? What happened to her?
Something strange is going on here. The automats will not come within 100 paces.
The King's orders, no doubt. He wants to protect his family from his own automats.
Sadly, Gabrielle got it into her head to explore the area to gauge the size of the enemy forces. The fool. She left so heedlessly that she was captured before our eyes and we couldn't do anything to help her.
Where did the automats take her?
They went towards the palace.
Run and get the children. They must not remain at Versailles any longer.
Have no fear, madame. I will take you to a place where all three of you will be safe.
I will help Madame de Polignac.
Dieu te vienne en aide. You are her only hope.
Don't delay, Aegis. Our companions are ready to take the palace as soon as you have destroyed its protectors. I will join you when I have fulfilled my commitment to Her Majesty.
Something has changed. The bond that tied me to the Queen. The force that compelled me to protect her. It's gone. It's been broken.
Thank you.
Estates General brandish the threat of rebellion. There is plotting afoot. They are stirring up the populace. Worse, they are making pacts. A number of representatives of the nobility and the clergy have taken up the cause of the Third Estate. As for my army, there is not a man among them I can trust. That is why I have made new arrangements for you. From now on, the Swiss Guard will no longer be protecting you.
Then who will, my love?
Take a look for yourself. Be assured you are in sturdier hands.
What? Whatever do you mean? Isn't that
Lutia? Monsieur Vaucanson's dancing doll?
Appearances can be deceiving, madame. The Count has made extraordinary improvements to this automat.
Aegis, this is Her Majesty the Queen. You are now to serve her. Make sure no harm comes to her and obey the orders she will give you.
Madame, I am at your service.
Patrolissa? He can speak. This makes no sense. This is sorcery.
Make no mistake, madame. It is science, which we owe to the work of the Count. And which will soon be made known to the entire world.
Courtyard is this way. Someone is expecting me. I can feel it. I must prepare for the worst.
Turns against its master.
You are not my master, tyrant. You never were.
I am quite happy to concede this point, but what about the Count? Have you forgotten that he gave you life and whispered the order that animates you? Look how he runs, the coward! Do you understand what he has in mind? La pauvre enfant, sleeping so sweetly, she won't be dreaming for long now!
Garçon! Athenaïs! Don't move!
The time has come to set you free, Aegis. This whore's soul has poisoned your cogs for too long. Adieu, sad puppet.
No!
Bonté divine, I don't want to die.
Athenaïs. The sun is rising, and you have slept for far too long. The beauty of this world longs for you, just as you long for its light. For you are like the flowers that open in the morning. I know you, mon ami. We loved each other. Vous en souvient-il? You gave me your heart. So please, let me give you mine today. Vive heureuse, Athenaïs. For it is happily that I leave this world.
This way, monsieur.
Thank you. Monsieur, we have the king. It is now up to us to wield his scepter. In this trying time, crucial decisions must be made without delay.
First and foremost, we must take back Paris.
And how do we do that, mon Dieu? There are automats everywhere, and they are constantly regenerated by their crimes.
We have the king. Cagliostro has fled, but he is leaving a trail of blood. I doubt he will survive his injuries. As a result, the automats are left to their own devices, with no one to give them orders and no reinforcements. And since I'm sure that Parisians will no longer venture out into the streets, the machines will soon have no more souls to harvest. Sooner or later, they will no longer be able to move and, par la grâce de Dieu, will become inanimate objects again. It's a matter of days, weeks at most.
Mais ensuite, once peace has been restored, what of the kingdom?
This is indeed a crucial issue. Leaving the nation without a government would expose it to the greatest danger.
Worse, it would condemn it to civil war.
Eh bien quoi, monsieur? Can you not govern together?
Unfortunately, the disagreements that divide our assembly run far too deep. That which we can agree is that we have been given a chance to choose the person who shall succeed the tyrant.
I claim this honor.
Excuse me? For what reason, je vous prie?
Enfin, simply consider the arguments for it.
Speak, Monsieur le Marquis. You have our full attention.
To begin with, I rescued the Dauphin from his father's clutches and ensured the dynasty's stability. The child will reign as Henri V. We will appoint someone with great wisdom to act as regent until he comes of age.
Fie. The people do not need a crowned puppet.
Yes, they do. Now more than ever before. Once the Assembly has adopted a constitution, the people will welcome a sovereign who will protect it.
A king and a constitution, like oil and water.
Go on, Monsieur le Marquis.
I have the gunpowder that the king had seized. With it, I shall ensure the security of the kingdom within and beyond its borders.
How can we be sure that you will not use it to oppress the people, or to embark on some foolhardy conquest? We know your ambitions, Monsieur le Marquis.
And you wrongly accuse me. I have never, in my entire life, done anything that was not to further the cause of freedom. Do you forget that in America I helped overthrow the English?
Of course not, mon ami. Who could forget that ruinous adventure?
You are quick to condemn men of action, provincial lawyer that you are. Monsieur, I rest my case.
Very well. Monsieur, we must now make our decision. May each of us respect this decision and set aside our personal interests for the sake of peace and the common good. Who among you approves the appointment of the Marquis de Lafayette? The court bows before the Marquis de Lafayette, Lieutenant General du Royaume.
Louis de Bourbon, former King of France, in the name of King Henri, fifth of his name, in light of the innumerable crimes of which you have been found guilty, this extraordinary royal court sentences you to the ultimate atonement. The sentence will be carried out on the hour. In its great mercy, the court will now hear your last words.
My loyal subjects, since you must lead a lamb to the altar, since you must offer a sacrifice to this new France that you intend to found, I will be that sacrifice. How dreadful this world is, where beauty is doomed to fade and flesh decays. I found no consolation in this world. I vainly thought I was giving our souls the gift of immortality beyond our mortal bodies. The Grim Reaper was my sworn enemy. Influenced by the most awful of men, I believed that the genius of machinery could overcome death itself. Alas, I have lost this fight, and am branded with a mark of murderer. Life, even more than the crown, was heavy for me to bear. I have suffered too long under the thumb of nature, which I despised. As a child, I saw my older brother die. I lost my father in the prime of his life, and then my mother, who was even younger. My beloved daughter did not live a year. As for my son, the first of my heirs, I unknowingly gave him to drink from a poisoned cup. I mourn the death of these poor souls daily. My death will not unite us, of this I am certain. For I, in my misery, have lost the support of my faith. So, executioner, lay me down on this board, Vertu. I will sleep now. Sleep at last, and not to dream.